So you want to see how I turn this into this? And watch until the end for some variations. Roll VT. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a group block, and this is going to be my container for everything. And I want that group block to be 850 pixels with a padding of about 5 top and bottom. And I'm also going to give it a color background of purple. So then I'm going to add a header, which is going to be called price table. And I want that to be a H1, or to center align the text, make it bold. And I also want the color to be white. I'm going to make the text size extra large and make it uppercase. And under my header, I want some placeholder text, and I also want that to be centered, and I'll make it white. So settings, color, text, white. Now I'm going to add a columns block, and because this is 3 price tables, I'm going to add 3 columns. With my columns selected, I want to make sure that the alignment is set to none and the vertical alignment is set to middle. I'm also going to add some padding top and bottom, and I'm also going to add it left and right, and I'll explain why. So if you ever wanted to give this columns block a color background, say for instance peach, and because we've added padding left and right, if we just check our mobile view, we can immediately see that we will have some space around our tables on a mobile device, which is what we want. So all I need to do now is to add some block space around what will be my pricing tables. So in my first column, I'm going to add in a group block, and this group block is going to be my pricing table, and I want to give that a color background of white. So styles, background, white. I also want to give it some padding top and bottom, and also left and right. I'm also going to give it a radius of 5, and this will give us a nice round edge. Then I'm going to add a stack for our heading and list, and I want those to be tight, so I'm going to make the block spacing 1, and I want to give it a uniform height of 250 pixels. So now I can add a heading for my price table. I'm just going to call that free, and I want to make that bold, and I also want to make it large, and I'm going to make it uppercase. And because I want to keep it tight to my list, I'm going to change the line space and set it to 1. Now I'm going to add my list, and I'm just going to Greek some text in here. And with my list selected, I'm going to set my padding, but I want to ensure that my left and right are set individually. So I'm going to set my left to 3 units and my right to 0. And this will just ensure that everything is lined up nicely. Now, ensuring my stack is selected, I'm going to press Option Command Y on a Mac, and this will ensure that the next block gets added after the first block. And I can check that by going to my list view and just making sure that the stack isn't embedded or inserted into the previous stack. So with my stack selected, I want to make sure that it's justified and the block spacing is set to 1. Because I'm going to put a price in, and I'm also going to put a button. So if I put my price in, I want to make sure that it's set to center aligned, bold, and also set to large. I'm going to set my button, I'm going to set that to sign up, and I want that center aligned, and I also want it 100% width, and I'm going to set the style to outline and also give it a 5 pixel radius. So now I want to move my toolbar. To do that, I go to options and then disable top toolbar, and this will ensure that the toolbar is above the block that I'm editing. Now with my group selected, I can go to my block options, hit duplicate, and now I've got access to the drag icon, and I can drag that to my second column, and that'll be my second price table. I can do exactly the same thing for this table. Go to my block options, duplicate, use the drag icon, and drag it to my third column. Now I've got 3 price tables. So for my middle price table, ensuring I've got my stack selected, I'm going to go to my settings and then style and set the minimum height to 320 pixels. And this will make the middle column pop. And all I need to do now is just make some fine adjustments. So I'm going to change some of the titles, add some more features, change the pricing, and change my third column title, add some features, change the price, and there you have it. A beautiful pricing table. And as promised, here are some variations. So if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments. Why not subscribe? Until then, I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.